Hi, today we're going to talk about a component from the future. The name of the component is Offscreen. I call it the future component for the reason that in the 18th version of React, this component is not available. In order to play with it, you have to install an experimental version of React. Here's how you can do it. Okay, enough announcements, and let's go. As I mentioned before, we've installed an experimental version of React to play with the component of the future. If you see something like these versions of React in package JSON, then you are on the right way. After all the preparations, we can move on to the actual component. The first thing to note is that we import the unstable off-screen component from React. I believe that in the future, the unstable prefix will disappear, and line number 3 will no longer be useful to us. So how the component works. In our case, off-screen wraps the title AI Bruise, and we see a property called mode with the value hidden. Let's go to the browser to see what we have programmed. So the screen is empty. The title is not visible anywhere, but in the dev tools, we see the title with the CSS property display none, and even marked with what important value. If we change the mode from hidden to visible, in this case, we will see the AI Bruise title. The only change in CSS is the removal of the display none property. Agree, it's a straightforward behavior. This can also be done with a simple toggle of CSS classes. So why React developers have created a separate component for it? To answer on the question, let's consider another example. In the current situation, we have a local variable called counter, and there is a button that increments the counter by 1 each time it is pressed. Next, we have the off-screen component, to which we pass visible if the counter is divisible by 3 and hidden in all other cases. And the last component is the sum component, to which we pass the current value of the counter. Now let's take a look at the code of the sum component component. Here everything is extremely simple. We display the value of the counter wrapped in a span tag and add an use effect to write a message mount when the component is mounted by console log function. I want to pay your attention to the fact that I pass an empty array of dependencies in useEffect. The idea is to see the message from console log only on the first mount of the component. We have studied the code base, and now I give you the opportunity to make a guess. As we already know, off-screen component with the mode hidden does not remove the HTML code from the DOM tree. It just hides it by display none. Therefore, I have two questions. The first one is, will the counter value be re-rendered every time if the off-screen component has mode hidden? And the second one is, how many times will the use effect be called during incrementing the counter from 0 to 9 if we specified an empty array of dependencies? Give you 3 seconds to pause the video and think of the answer. 3, 2, 1. So, let's go to the browser and see what we got. On the screen, we see the increment button, the counter from some component, which will disappear and appear. On the right, we see the HTML structure of our page, and the same counter that hides if the counter is not divisible by 3. Let's try to increment the counter up to 9, and let's see what happens in the DevTools during it. As you can see, the counter is hidden when the number is not divisible by 3, but at the same time, the component continues to do updates even if the next value is not displayed. Based on it, we can do the first conclusion. If we pass new props to hidden components, the hidden component will also be updated. Now we can switch to the console tab and see how many times console.log was called. And here we see in a total of 4 times. And I remind you that we passed an empty array of dependencies and expected the use effect to be called only on component mount. How does it work? Every time we change the mode from hidden to visible, the use effect is called. In our case, console.log was called when the counter was 0, 3, 6, and 9. As a result, we got a completely new rendering option for the application. When we wrap something in the off-screen component and specify mode with value hidden, on the one hand, the HTML code is rendered and updated as if the component is mounted and is simply hidden at the CSS level. But on the other hand, the component's lifecycle behaves as if the component has been removed from the virtual tree. After more detailed testing, I can add a few nuances to this behavior. When the mode changes from visible value to hidden, the component's unmount callback, or component will unmount, is called. I also tested how it works with Redux. Imagine we have a component wrapped in off-screen with mode hidden, and inside the component, useSelector is used to retrieve the user. The question is, will the hidden component be rendered if someone from the outside updates the user? The answer is no, there will be no rendering. This functionality is also disabled in hidden mode, and the last thing I tested is whether the component retains its own state after changing the mode from visible to hidden. It turned out that the state is preserved until the node is explicitly removed from the DOM tree. That's what I managed to find out during the initial examination of this component. The mechanics are completely different from what we're used to. We have discovered the new mechanics of the off-screen component, but what I would also like to find out is what motivated the React team to create such a component. For this, I'm going to show you some quotes from the React blog, where we're described a couple of options of the off-screen component usage. The first one is instant transitions between pages. Some libraries, upon hovering over a link, start preloading the next page to speed up the transition to the next screen. Just imagine, for instance, React Router will be able to start pre-rendering the next page in the background under the hood and switch the mode from hidden value to visible when needed. Sounds quite impressive, but from other side, it looks like phones will start discharging even faster. The second strong point is that the state is not lost when the component is hidden. Now, for example, if you switch between tabs, you can store the state of all tabs and instantly switch between them while preserving even the scroll state. This can be done not only with tabs, but also with multi-step forms, modal windows, and so on. This opens up a whole new range of possibilities for us. The next example of usage is virtual infinite lists. We can pre-render more rows than are currently visible, and we can do it with lower priority than rendering visible rows. I think it refers to React's internal prioritization of rendering tasks. I found another article that analyzes all the React source code within the interaction with the off-screen component. At the end of the article, we can see an interesting conclusion. The whole purpose of this process is to put the rendering of hidden stuff into a lower priority. This is the goal of concurrent mode. Therefore, we can assume that React will render hidden components as the very last priority and won't trigger the lifecycle of these components. In the end, it sounds very promising to me. I look forward to using all of this in my projects. If you liked this format of reviewing future React, write a comment about it, and I will make more videos like this. Meanwhile, the biggest thank you would be to like, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell, as there is no spam on this channel. Bye!